Salvete, Latin scholars. Odie est pulchra dies. Ut linguam latinam disceamus. Quid agitis?
Bene. Laeti. Parat linguam latinam discere sumus.
Bene. Ego etiam me bene abeo. Okay, so last time on Agora Academy, we learned the rules for forming the future tense endings. And today, we're going to look at the endings chart and then figure out how to translate the endings. Same thing we did with the imperfect endings. In the upcoming lessons, we'll review the entire present system and think of all three tenses, the present, imperfect, and future, as working together. So if you feel like you're still getting things a little mixed up, that's okay. This is all still new, and there's more review coming. But for now, onward into the future. Okay, so now let's review the steps for forming the future tense. As I'm sure you know by now, the future tense is part of the present system, which means that you form it using the present stem. You find the present stem by going to the second principal part and chopping off the RE. Then, you add in the robot sounds. That's bo, be, 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 boo. Bo, be, 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 boo. Then all you do is add the personal endings. Remember, since there's already an O in the first person singular, bo is fine just the way that it is. So the future tense endings are bo, bis, beat, bimus, bitis, boont. Again, that's bo, bis, beat, bimus, bitis, boont. So let's try an example and conjugate amo, amare in the future tense. We go to the second principal part and drop the RE to get our stem. And that means we end up with amabo, amabis, amabit, amabimus, amabitis, amabunt. One note on the third person plural, you'll notice that except for the first person singular, the future tense is characterized by the B, B-I letter combination. Except in the third person plural, it becomes a bu, B-U. Why do you think that is? You'll actually see this happen in several sets of endings. It turns out that Latin simply doesn't like the INT letter combination. So any time that it would make logical sense to have an INT ending based on the rules, the I will generally turn into a U. That's a pattern that stays very consistent in Latin. There is one exception which occurs in the future perfect tense, but of course you don't have to worry about that yet. Okay, so you can conjugate a verb in the future tense. But how do you translate it? Well, let me ask you this. How do you talk about events in the future? If you were going to tell me about your plans for next summer, or next year, or 10 years from now, what helping verb would you use?
Will.
What was that?
Will.
That's right, you would use will. So let's go back to our conjugations for amo, amare. The first person singular, amabo, would be I will love. The second person singular, amabis, is you will love. Then amabit, he, she, or it will love. Amabimus, we will love. Amabitis, you all will love. And amabun, they will love. What about laudo? You find the stem, then conjugate it with the bo, bis, beat, bimus, bitis, bunt endings. So it is lauda bo, lauda bis, lauda beat, lauda bimus, lauda bitis, lauda bun. Or, I will praise, you will praise, he, she, or it will praise, we will praise, you all will praise, they will praise. Okay? Great work, scholars! You can keep practicing with the future tense endings and their translations in the exercises following the video. Bonam fortunam, valete!